Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment.
Welcome to Brighton Lights, latest TV's weekly What's On show. I'm your host, Joe Fuller, and my personal highlights this week are Mitski, Frive, and Hedda Gabler. I'll be covering highlights in film, music, comedy, stage, events, and gaming, so stay tuned. Logan stars your usual X-Men suspects like Hugh Jackman and Patrick Stewart, but also features Stephen Merchant and Richard E. Grant. You can check out a funnier, expletive-ridden trailer online, but this more TV-friendly one gives you a feel for the film anyway.
Hello. You know you gotta pay for that, right? Hey, come on.
Not okay!
Fist Fight is directed by Richie Keene, who directed several episodes of the brilliant It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia, so it could be good. His directorial film debut stars Tracy Morgan from 30 Rock, Ice Cube, and Christina Hendricks.
Two teachers are in a school fight to end all school fights.
You're about a teacher fight?
Hashtag teacher fight!
The whole school's into it. We're gonna tailgate.
You're the nice guy, and then people are like, hey, I'm gonna stomp on that guy.
You got this! I don't think he's got this.
Why don't you just take a punch and then just go down?
Judging by early festival reviews, Trespass Against Us sadly sounds like it adds up to less than the sum of its parts. You'd think that Gleason and Fassbender in a family drama would be a winner, but Jordan Hoffman from The Guardian wrote that it fails to convince you its leading men are sympathetic.
Start raining down on all of us, and they will break you on your own. You know that. But not if we stay tight.
Do what they say, kids.
This is your fault. You know that.
I love you so much.
I'm getting away from you, Cole.
You forget who you are, boy.
I'm just trying to look after my family.
I'm your family.
The UK premiere of Danza will be broadcast live from the London Palladium, and you can see a satellite Q&A with Sergei Polunin, as well as a performance after the screening. This looks like a great one-off screen arts event, which could really complement the documentary.
When I was little, I had such a passion.
My family moved around the world to support me. If the
heavens ever did, that's when I guess fun was over. I would do ballet twice more than normal because I knew that's my chance to get my family back together.
Sergei, I think he's always suffered silently.
His family was broken.
I wasn't able to make everything good.
I love Mitski. Puberty 2 is the indie rock album I listened to the most last year. The songs are consistently brilliant, the lyrics refreshingly candid, and the guitar and vocals are attention-grabbing. If you go to one gig this weekend, make it this one. You're the sun, you've never seen the night, but you hear a song.
I'm not even a star, but a
The drive-by truckers gig is sold out, but they're so good that you should keep an eye on social media for any resales. Their most recent album, American Band, was released before the election and explores issues such as Islamophobia and the NRA. It could be interesting seeing what they have to say about the state of the US at the moment, or you can just go along and enjoy some really good songs.
When he reached the gates of heaven, he didn't understand. Near the friends were coming over. Was it all a dream? Was it all a crazy dream? Saw them playing there before him. What were they doing there?
For a different slice of American music, you could try the Handsome Family, who were made famous when Far From Any Road was selected for the theme tune of True Detective.
Got a tattoo of a snake and a ski mask on my face, but I won't. Stop and go, lying in the weeds with a bullet in my gut.
Having gone through a sort of soft transformation from guitars to dance pop, Kaiser Chiefs play at the Brighton Centre this Tuesday to promote their album Stay Together. You can hear their new direction in the music video for Hole in My Soul.
Strike up the band, give yourself a great big hand, and all together now, all together now, strike up the
Thrive is a production aimed at young people which uses humour, movement and spoken word to portray the experience of trauma and how to feel optimistic when dealing with it. Inspired by true stories, it looks like the show shouldn't be too maudlin judging by the trailer. Reviews have also praised it for being amusing, so don't worry if you're wary of stuff that's too dark. Based on the children's book by Claire Friedman, Monstersaurus follows a young inventor called Monty. Monty creates a world of monsters and inventions, but then has to try to get rid of them.
Do you dare me to make a monster?
Yeah!
Hit it! It could be tall, it could be small, it could be anything at all. I'm gonna make me a monster. I'm gonna make me a monster. I'm going to need your help. There are lots of funny ingredients, and I'm not sure if I've got them all myself.
I saw George Dillon last year revisiting some older shows and was really captivated by his impressive technical proficiency. Words seemed to leap out of him in wild bursts or in quieter, more contemplative tones. This Saturday sees him revisit 2002's The Gospel of Matthew by Candlelight at St. Luke's Church.
If you're the Son of God, order these stones to become bread. It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. It's not those who say to me, Lord, Lord, who will enter the kingdom of heaven, but those who do the will of my Father in heaven. Look. The farmer is sowing, and as he sows, some of the seed falls by the roadside, and the birds come along, ah, ah, and they eat it up.
Pink Mist was inspired by interviews with returned servicemen and first stage at the Bristol Old Vic in 2015. Owen Shears' story about the physical and psychological aftershocks of war will be at Eastbourne from next Tuesday. We'll be right back. That's all for part one. Don't go away because we have comedy, events and gaming after the break.
Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment. Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment.
Welcome back to Brighton Lights Part 2. I'm Joe Fuller and I'm now going to tell you about more great events in and around Brighton. Tiff Stevenson did a gig in David Lynch's nightclub in Paris last year when she met Josh Homme and Brody Dalle 1 month before the Bataclan attacks. In Seven, she discusses the need to make huge worldwide events about us, while also exploring morality, film reboots, social media, and mental health.
I did hang out with the nerds at school, though. My best mate at school was a guy called Lube. Now, I should probably explain that isn't a sexy nickname. It's because he had really bad psoriasis and used to carry around a pot of Vaseline with him everywhere. I know, that's quite nerdy, isn't it? He actually once tried to chat me up by reciting the entire periodic table. I was like, shh, stop. You had me at boron. Teenagers are cruel though, aren't they? I can't understand them. I find them quite confusing with their three haircuts on one head. Just pick one and stick with it. Speaking in acronyms, but not really knowing what acronyms are. I told a joke to a group of 17-year-olds recently about Chairman Mao, and I realised they'd never seen the letters M-A-O without an L in front of them.
Bridget Christie's show, Because You Demanded It, is for everyone. It's about leaving the EU, and she claims that even if you voted leave, then you'll still find the show funny, because you can witness her exasperated and despairing meltdown.
What's your choice?
Kardashians have babies, you know. You didn't mind those going in the room.
Well, okay, so obviously they're very cute. If they weren't cute, the human race would have died out a long time ago because early humans would have gone, okay, I've done 3 days now, I'm out. That's enough. I just think they're overrated.
Paul Sinha headlines a fundraising event for the Blatchington Court Trust, a Hove-based charity that supports children with visual impairments. The generous bill also includes Laura Lex, Phil Gerrard, Elf Lyons and Tiernan Dueb.
Now, as you can imagine, when I decided I want to pursue a career as a full-time stand-up comedian, my parents thrilled for me, absolutely delighted, simply couldn't be happier. They ring me every day of my life to tell me this, that when they arrived on this beautiful island in 1968, it wasn't their dream come true that their only son had a British education and became a clown. That's right, 48 long years ago is when my mum and dad made the same decision we now know half of India made, looked at the map of the world, went, America, too exciting, we're coming to Britain. Odd choice? No. Perfect choice. I'll tell you why. 1960s, there's your clue. Here are the options. Birmingham, Alabama. Birmingham, West Midlands. Forced to sit at the back of the bus. Get to drive the bus.
Charlie Baker sings pop songs but polishes them up to become supposedly groovy new favourites. Joined by Sean Hargreaves on the Hammond organ, you can expect songs such as Cotton-Eyed Woe, along with some stand-up.
If you're from Devon, trying to break into the jazz world, it's almost impossible because there's no one to follow into it, you see? There's no, like, icons from Devon in the jazz world. There's no, like, Rat Pack. There's no, ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome to the stage from Torquay, Mr. Sammy Davis Jr. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Who can take a sunrise, sprinkle it with dew, kaleidoscope a colour in a miracle or two, the Tractor Man. Hey, the Tractor Man.
Patrick Marber, the writer of Closer and Don Juan in Soho, has penned a new version of Ibsen's play Hedda Gabler. Ruth Wilson's performance has drawn acclaim from critics, and you can see what the fuss is about with a live cinema screening if you don't fancy braving the trains to get to London.
Hey, look at Hedda. Look how lovely she is.
That's not news. She's been lovely all her life.
Yes.
How could you ask those things?
How could you answer?
I still don't know, and you're saying it wasn't love. What we had. Weren't you trying to save me?
Not in the least.
Then what?
It's over now.
But the journey ahead is love.
Yeah, you can always end a journey or break it. You simply jump off the train.
I love multimedia shows since I think they can help bring art forms to a wider audience, and Scattered at Worthing looks like a fine interaction between film and dance. It's suitable for all of the family, so presumably there's no naked bodies in this one. Deborah Pearson presents a live documentary which explores the personal and the political while projecting a Hungarian film. The film is a 1956 football comedy which Pearson will loosely translate while discussing a story of writers, actors, and a country that's lost its revolution. Really looking forward to this one, where Danza Contemporánea de Cuba return to Brighton with their unique blend of jazzy American modernism, ballet, and Afro-Caribbean rhythms. You can get a taste of the diverse pieces from the following trailer. The Nintendo Switch is released this Friday. I think that the concept is a bit confusing with it being a home console and portable hybrid, and also that the £280 price tag is a little intimidating. But there looks like some great potential in the console, such as the ability to set up a local multiplayer game anywhere you like. The clear launch title highlight is The Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild. The world of Hyrule looks stunning, and there are over 100 shrines to explore which you can tackle in any order you like. Plus, you can tame wild horses, battle large beasts, and use the Wolf Link amiibo if that's your sort of thing.
I think you are now ready. Ready to hear what happened 100 years ago.
Until now, it was all for nothing.
1-2 switch is a curious proposition designed to showcase what the Joy-Con controllers can do. It looks like a collection of mini-games such as draining milk through an udder, some of which barely need the screen to work. It looks like fun, but maybe should have been included with the console like Wii Sports was, rather than being available as a separate title. The final launch title I want to show you is Super Bomberman R, which has been created by members of the original Bomberman team. It therefore harks back to some of the classic gameplay, which is a brilliant local multiplayer experience.
To restore peace in the universe, now rise the eight brothers.
That's all for today. Thanks for watching. If you have any shows that you'd like to be considered for a mention on Brighton Lights, then you can email me at editorial@thelatest.co.uk.
Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment.